Okay, by the end of this video, here's what you're gonna have. You are gonna have your blog up and running. You're gonna have free access to my 20 lesson blogging course. It will teach you everything you need to know about your blog and how to use it. And additionally, you will have your blog set up in a way that will give you the best possible chance to make money from it. Because unfortunately, there are so many different types of blogs that you can start that actually hinder your ability to make money from that. And as someone who has been making a full-time living for my blog for a decade now, this is important. It's important that we get compensated for the work that we do, that we put into our blogs. And so I'm gonna help you do that and maximize the amount of money that you can earn from your blog. All right, so with all that out of the way, if you're ready to get started, let's dive right in. So we should be able to move through this pretty quick and get like all this underlying stuff taken care of in hopefully about 10 minutes or so. So just feel free to pause the video and just follow along right along with me as we go through this. Now, if you do want to get our free 20 lesson course after all of this, then here is the link that you can use and you should be able to click on it down below. But if it's not there, you can just type this in and you can use that. Additionally, if you go through this link, you're going to save 45% off of the standard price for hosting. Okay, so that sounds really great. And you might be wondering why we would give you this course for free. Well, the truth is that almost any guide that you follow on how to set up a blog, they're going to get a commission from the hosting company that they're pointing you to. So in our case, you know, we're going to get a commission as well. But I just feel like let's just kind of toss that back to you a little bit and kind of share in that reward. But anyway, we can get into those details in a little bit. But for now, let's get going. Let's get you up and running and get your blog started. And then we can kind of talk about those details later. Now, I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time talking about why we're choosing HostGator, but I will say this. I've been doing this for 10 years. I've used 6 different web hosts from price points from the absolute cheapest to really, really expensive. And I have recommended HostGator to thousands of new bloggers over those years. And all in all, this is just my favorite host for new bloggers. Once you're a bit more established, I don't think it's the best host. I think there are better options for you. But as a new blogger, I think this is the best place to start. It is the best value in terms of price that you're paying and customer support that you are going to get. All right, now that we have all that out of the way, this should be something similar to what you're seeing when you land on the page. They're always tweaking and changing these pages, so it might be a little bit different. Don't worry about it. But essentially, they should have a hatchling plan, which is their cheapest, and then a baby, and then a business plan. For most new bloggers, I would recommend the hatchling plan or the baby plan. The big difference between the two is with the hatchling plan, you can only have one domain on your hosting account. Meaning, you know, if it's joesblog.com, that's all you can have. So if you wanted to start joesblog.com and then you wanted to start a cooking blog and then you wanted to start, you know, a travel blog, you would have to purchase a separate hosting package or upgrade your hosting package to do that. So if you're thinking that you might want to create another blog in the future, the baby plan might be a little bit better because you can have multiple blogs on that one hosting account. We'll just start with the hatchling plan for now, so you can just click the little button to get started. So if you do not have your domain picked out, here's what I recommend doing. Go over to a website called domize.com. And this is one of my favorite places to find domain names that are available. So if we're looking for Joe's cooking blog, so what we can see, so whatever we're typing here, you can see what is available. So the red is not, but the blue is. So if we wanted to get Joe's cooking blog, we could get that .com, we could get the .co, the .net, or .org. And so that's what we're looking for, something where you're seeing blue here. What's cool about this is you can just kind of search different keyword phrases related to your blog that you're thinking about doing, and this will help immensely. All right, so let's just say we're gonna go with mycookingblog.org. So we know that that's available. So what we'll do is we'll come back over to HostGator, and then we'll enter in that domain that we're gonna get. Cooking blog, we're gonna get the .org, which they have down here. And then it says that is available, it shows that it's available. And there's a whole bunch of other ones, but all we need to do is get that one right now. Now, if you already have your domain, what you can do is just enter that in over here. So now that we have mycookingblog.org, what we're gonna do is come on over here, select our, we got this selected, the hatchling plan. Now, to get the absolute cheapest price, you need to sign for the longest term. So they have a 3-year term, and that's how you get the $382 a month. So what you can do, you know, if you don't want to sign a 3-year thing, which, you know, I understand, You can get a much shorter term, as short as even a single month. And so it's going to be a little bit more expensive, but it's still $6 a month. So it's still ridiculously cheap. And then what you want to do at this point is just, so we'll just change that to one just for this one. You can enter in your username. You can enter in your security PIN, and then you can enter in all of your billing information as well. Now for the additional services, personally, what I don't do the site lock, I don't do the site backup, I don't do any of their stuff. The only thing I might do is backup above where we have domain privacy protection. I might do this. It's $1.25 a month. And so essentially what this does is when you buy a domain, your information is out on the internet. So it shows people who owns that domain. So my cooking blog, it's going to say that Bob Lodic owns this, and it's going to show my business address and possibly even whatever phone number I provide. So if you want to stay private with that and keep that information private, then you can add this on for $1.25 a month. So it's your choice, but I tend to do that with most of my domains. Oh, and I should add that $1.25 a month is not tied to your hosting, but the domain itself. So in this particular example, even though we're only getting 1 month of hosting, we're going to have the domain for a year, and it's going to charge us $1.25 each month. So that would be $15 additional that we would need to pay today for that. But all these additional services I don't get. You can always get them later if you'd like. And then enter in the coupon code. It should put this in automatically if you click the link. If not, you can just type in SeedTime, and then it'll knock off 45% for you. All right, and then down here, we can see everything we're going to get. 365 days a year phone, chat, and email support, which is great. Instant account activation, money-back guarantee. So you have 45 days to get your money back if you decide not to do it. You're having your domain registration for 1 year, and then you have the hosting plan for 1 month, and that's $6. And then you have the discount there, and that gives you a total of $18.97 today. And so then you just click checkout. And one more thing I should add, they are changing their prices somewhat regularly. So these prices might be a little bit different for you, and I do apologize if they're a little bit higher than what we're showing here. But the bottom line is, trust me, this is a really low-cost host that provides great service, so it's still worth it. All right, and then now we're just waiting for them to get the account all set up. And this just might take a couple minutes for you, so just be patient. All right, and then this is the page you're going to land on after your account is set up. So the next thing you want to do is head over to your email. You're going to be getting two separate emails from them. One is for all the billing information, and then the other is for the account login information. Normally it comes pretty quick, but if it happens to take a while for you, you can jump on the chat box with the folks over at HostGator, let them know you just set up your account, you're waiting for your login information, and sometimes they can expedite that for you. So this is an example of one of these account information emails and what you will be receiving. It'll look something like this. So right here where it says control panel, you can just click this link and open this in a new tab. And then you can copy and paste your username. And we're going to paste that in just a second here. And then just go ahead and copy your password. And we'll paste that in as well. All right, and now that we're logged in, this is what you are going to see. And this is the cPanel area. And this is kind of the under the hood area of your hosting account. And so honestly, like, I almost never come in here. This is one of those things where you're just setting this up at the beginning and you really shouldn't have to come in here very much. And honestly, there's still a lot of stuff in here. I just don't even know what it does. And so you just don't need to know much about what's in here, but we need to get WordPress installed, and that's why we're going to come in here. So what we're going to do here is just go ahead and click this click install button and then click WordPress. We're just going to select our domain name from the dropdown and then hit next. Now we're entering the information for us to set up our WordPress blog. So we have our hosting account set up, but now we're setting up the WordPress blog, and that is where you're going to spend most of your time as a blogger, is in the WordPress blog itself. So put in the blog title, we'll put in the admin user, first and last name, and then our email address. And then you can just hit install now, and we can get WordPress installed. All right, so now it is installing, so just hang tight. And then once it is complete, you will see this little installation complete or some variation of it. Again, this is one of those things that they occasionally are changing, so if it looks a little bit different, don't worry. So what you can do at this point is just click this link here. This will take you over to your blog, and you're not going to see much yet, but you can just click that. And your site, again, might look very different than this, but at the time of this recording, this is how they're handling it after you have installed your WordPress installation. And so what you're going to want to do here is click admin login. All right, and I should add, if you click on the link of your blog and you are seeing something here showing that it's not set up, then what that probably means is that the DNS is still propagating around the internet. And essentially what that means is that it's just going to take a little bit more time for this information to get all through the internet over to where you are. And so a lot of times this happens really, really quickly, but sometimes depending on where you're located and what kind of internet service provider you're using, it takes a little bit longer. In some cases, it can take over 24 hours. Like, I rarely see that happening. Most cases, it seems to happen within a few minutes and sometimes an hour, but it is possible. So just be aware of that if you're not seeing it. And again, this is a great time to jump on chat support with HostGator if you're having any issues and if you're seeing something different than what we're showing you here. But if you are seeing something like this and you have this admin login option, just go ahead and click this button and we will get you logged in. And this is where you go to get logged into your WordPress dashboard. So I would bookmark this link because you're going to need to come back to this often. Every time you write a new blog post, you're going to have to come here, and this is where you're going to be spending a lot of your time. Okay, so the username and password information is what you just entered a minute ago to create the quick install for WordPress. And so I know there's a lot of usernames and passwords and things, but I'm going to break it down into three main things that you have going on. So the first one email that you got was billing for HostGator. And so that's going to manage all of your billing stuff. It's all going to be taken care of through that. The next one is for cPanel. And this is like the server stuff with your hosting. And both of those two things I very rarely go into. And the third username and password is for WordPress. And this is where I spend most of my time and where you will spend most of your time as a blogger. So that's the one that you'll be using on a regular basis. But the other two are important, and I would save them for those times when you will need them. Enter in the username and the password that you just entered when you were setting up your WordPress site. All right, so you are now logged in, and this is the back end of your WordPress, and this is going to be where you create pages, where you create posts, you know, if you were going to upload any kind of videos or audio, any of that stuff. This is all where you're going to be making those changes. So our Start Your Blog 20 video course is going to teach you everything you need to know about WordPress and how to actually use your blog. And to get access to that course, all I need you to do is forward one of the HostGator emails that they sent you over to lauren@seedtime.com. And as soon as we get that information from you, we will forward you a coupon code that will knock off 100% of the price so you can get that course completely for free. But for now, I want to talk just for a few minutes and give you a little bit of a primer on what you need to know to start making money from your blog. First thing you need to do is you actually have to write a little bit of content. And so I would suggest getting about 10 articles out on your site before you actually start trying to make any money from it. The other reason is that one of the best and easiest ways to make money from your blog is a ad program called AdSense. And this is Google's program. And I'm sure you've seen these ads because they're probably on like 80% of all the websites on the entire internet. They're just really, really common, and it's one of the easiest ways to monetize a website or a blog. And to be approved for the AdSense program, you have to have a little bit of content on your site. The Google AdSense people want to know that you didn't start your blog yesterday and that you actually have a good amount of content on there before they allow you to put ads up. So to get you started off on the right foot, here's what I suggest. Write 10 articles on your blog, and then I would go over to AdSense.com and sign up for their AdSense program. Once you get that, they will give you just a little piece of code that you can easily add to your blog. If you go through our video course, there'll be a lesson in there that will show you kind of where you would want to put that. And if for some reason you don't get approved for the Google AdSense program, there's an alternative that I would recommend called media.net. They're a pretty big competitor to AdSense. There are some things they do a little bit differently, but if you can't get into AdSense, that's probably the next best option of how you can start monetizing the articles on your blog.